Start off with today, and this is a new story that's just gotten crazy, and I'm going to shorten it up as much as possible. College student goes into mass, walks out, walks over, gets his communion wafer, and goes back and sits down. Now, the Catholic Church is now, most of them, instead of putting it in your mouth on your tongue, they put it right in your hand, and you're supposed to immediately consume it. Mm-hmm. I think they do this for sanitation reasons, If you're really, you know, putting the body of Christ in your mouth, do you really have to be concerned about sanitation? I mean, is your God so weak and feeble that he can't, like, also sanitize the biscuit in the priest's hands? But so anyway, he goes back and he sits down, and somebody saw him. Mm-hmm. Somebody saw him not immediately eat the cracker. And the policy of this church is, I kid you not, to physically restrain anybody who attempts to not eat the cracker. And so a woman came over and grabbed his wrist and restrained him, tried to pry open his hand to get the cracker out. And finally he put it in his mouth to satisfy all of them, then left and took it back out of his mouth and put it in a plastic bag and held on to it. Now, while I find all this incredibly amusing, Catholics didn't. Who knew?
Who knew?
And the part about this that, you know, while I find all this funny, I also find it incredibly sad, because Catholics have lost their damn minds over this cracker. Going on television, equating it with kidnapping. Mm-hmm. I kid you not, kidnapping.
Because Jesus is a real human, and the cracker turned into Jesus.
The cracker turned into Jesus, and it's kidnapping, or it's close to kidnapping. Well, why don't you go tell that to the parents of kidnapped victims? And instead of crying over this cracker, where's the outrage over pedophile priests and all the other problems that your church is doing, like supporting global gag rules and failing to and working in opposition to proper sex prophylactic sex education, things like that. Where's the outrage over that? Somebody steals a cracker and you guys lose your minds. And Bill Donahue from the Catholic League is way up at the top of the lost your mind list. So PZ Myers of the Fringula blog, who was on a nonprofit show recently, decided to take him to task for this and just say, and said, you know, hey, it's a cracker, get over it. And made fun of them and said that, you know, if somebody could score him some consecrated communion wafers, he'd be happy to desecrate them and post them about him on his blog. And I support PZ for that. But the Catholics went nuts again and started a letter writing campaign to the president of the university where PZ works, possibly asking him to be fired or lose his job or whatever. So
that's a tactic that the Catholic League uses.
Well, I mean, what he did was he exercised protected speech. They can't possibly go after him for that. So they're going to try and affect his livelihood, mm-hmm, by going after him. And, you know, they're going to throw their weight around and try and strong-arm university. And I'm sure the president of the university has received threats of removing students and denying grants and all kinds of other things. I hope the university stands firm and supports him, because PZ Myers is a credit to the University of Minnesota Morris and to scientists everywhere, to anybody who's embracing reason. But, so what I did today, I did not get my hands on pre-consecrated wafers. I'm going to do that. I'm also going to encourage other people to do that in what I dubbed yesterday as the Eucharist Challenge. But it turns out there's also another Eucharist Challenge that's on YouTube that was posted yesterday. So rather than fight the guy over the idea,
This is
just me, and it's for my own interest to see who can do it and whether they can get away with it. Number one rule, do not, under any circumstances, disrupt someone's church service. I can't stress that enough. I won't even consider any videos or talk about any kind of positive light, no matter how creative you are, if you disrupt their church service. These people have a constitutional right to exercise their crazy beliefs. They need to, if you go in there and act as a disruption, you make the rest of us look bad during their service. All you need to do is go in to a Catholic Mass and walk out with one of those after it's been consecrated by a priest, because that's, of course, when it becomes the host.
Mm-hmm.
It becomes part of the body of Christ. Now, I don't think DNA analysis and other lab tests will show that these ever become anything more than the bits of wheat flour and water, tasteless crap that they are. But if you can get out with one and videotape yourself with it, you can post it on YouTube and send it. Also, you can get creative. If you could get like a whole bunch of these, you could maybe mold them into like a little Jesus voodoo doll. because we got, I mean, so I actually, being an ordained minister, I'm going to go ahead and on my own consecrate. I have a whole bunch of them here. I don't know if you
How'd
can see it.
How'd you get to be ordained, man?
Online, 3 minutes, Universal Life Church, easy as pie. I can forgive sins. According to the website, I can forgive sins, conduct marriages, funeral ceremonies, and I'm going to consecrate communion wafers. So I consecrate thee, all of you. I know priests do it one at a time, but I'm way better. So now we've got consecrated communion wafers. Would you
thank you.
Try one? We're gonna be rude and eat on TV, but they're pretty tasteless pieces of crap, really.
I like cardboard.
They are. And by the way, just to prove that I'm magic, that atheism is magic, and that these crackers are truly consecrated now, I'm gonna go ahead and you can zoom in a little more. I want to make sure that. No, not that, yeah. If you rip these crackers, now that I've consecrated them, they are so unholy because of the atheist blessing that they will actually go back together just like that into one piece.
Ooh, ah.
But, yeah, it's, you know, I'm going to have a lot of fun with this. By the way, Jesus goes good with cheese.
Okay.
Got some good queso.
Okay, what body part was that?
It wasn't an organ. That one actually, I don't like organs. I mean, I'm hoping to avoid like spleen and liver and things like that. I think that was an earlobe.
Oh, okay.
A little waxy.
Well, it's easy for me to understand why the Catholic Church and the Catholic people are so up in arms about this. And the reason is pretty simple. It's that the Catholic Church has for many, many years run a scam where they give out crackers and they get money for crackers. It's a cracker scam of some sort, right? They bless the crackers and they
crackety
give it
ass out. Cracker.
And they make lots of money this way. That's how they operate. And if somebody's coming and grabbing their crackers and doing something and showing people like we are that they're just crackers, then they kind of lose some potential income. And I imagine they'll be mad at us today for doing this very same thing.
My roommate was raised Catholic. And like most people who were raised Catholic, he eventually ended up taking communion. But he was telling me that he couldn't do it in first grade because he hadn't passed the communion test, which I think is like some kind of IQ test, but I'm not sure. And in second grade, he was allowed to do it. And he said
catechism,
the whole thing was,
right?
Yeah, the whole thing was that, you know, he didn't really understand it, didn't care about it, but everybody else got to do this, and he felt excluded.
That's peer pressure,
so he
right?
couldn't wait till he could come get one of these tasty wheat. What happens if you're allergic to wheat?
Yeah, celiac disease.
And the Catholic Church evidently requires that they be made of wheat, although maybe they're...
We were talking at breakfast, you know, are they meat or are they vegetable?
They're vegetable first, and then after I consecrate them,
they become meat.
And yes. You know,
so the vegetarians are excluded here too, right? Not just the celiac.
That was a toenail. You can't always get the best bits of Jesus. Christ on a cracker, that one was bad.
You're going to keep chowing
down,
right?
Nibbling on Jesus, because as long as there's
queso, you're not going to want to have dinner.
Jesus tastes good.
We're going to dinner later, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
Okay.
We're going to dinner at Threadgill's. I'm talking with my mouth full.
Okay, after the show, we're going to Threadgill's. We'll be there about 5:30.
That was a rib. I love ribs.
Yeah.
Did I mention I'm forgetful today? But of course, the big number one rule with this Eucharist challenge thing is don't disrupt anybody's service, which means, you know, don't go screaming, "I'm stealing Jesus," you know, and run out of their church. But you can film as much of it as you can. I don't imagine it'd be very easy to actually film going into a Catholic church. And we are in no way responsible for any trouble you get into. So this is basically kind of a, you know, have fun with it. Man.
Okay.
Anyway.
All right.